I'm ready.
Hello again, this is Jeff of TAOFLEDERMAUS. We have another completely out-of-the-box shotgun slug designed by no other than Tim Hamilton of Ballistic Machinist channel. And no, this is not a spool valve out of a hydraulic system or a shuttle valve or anything like that. This was purposely made by Tim to tumble through the air, but it sure does look like a little tiny dumbbell made for G.I. Joe.
All right, we're going to be shooting these. Do you even curl, bro? These are the dumbbell rounds sent by Tim. You can see they make a perfect little dumbbell, and we put them in a little plastic shot cup.
That's the way Tim loaded them, so we did it the same way.
Shot cup there and a covering.
Yep, be careful loading that thing. Definitely against the Geneva Convention. Be sure to let Colonel Clink know that.
Okay, first target is our gigantic computer hard drive.
Don't hit my table.
Ready?
I'm ready. Wow.
And like I said, these were designed to tumble through the air. But look at this crazy display of bizarro supersonic aerodynamics. And that's why I love this stuff so much. The slug is actually flying perfectly straight through the air. It is attached still to the plastic wadding. So maybe that's the reason the drag from the wadding is causing it to fly straight.
Tim, that was accurate AF, because that was landing right where I was aiming.
That was up, right?
Yeah, it was standing up.
Can you
right?
Get it out of there? Or?
Yeah.
Look at that. If it's balanced, it will be accurate. That's one thing. There's still some wadding on there. Oh, it's a little bit broken off.
Not bad, though.
We could shoot that thing again, though. That's great.
Or lift with it.
Lift. Do you lift, bro?
Careful, bro. Let me keep the reps down below 10.
Okay, I'm ready.
All right, no laser, but I'm going to go for the center.
Again, the wadding is stuck to the back of the slug, and again, it flew perfectly straight through the air. One thing I've noticed about Tim's slugs and his workmanship is everything is so precise that the behaviors of one slug are usually exhibited in all the slugs.
Oh. Hit there. Just about wanted to break through the other side.
But are they tumbling? That's the... You'll never get it out of there, I bet.
Throw it in there.
Wow. Okay. What else can we shoot?
Off of his head if you want.
Huh?
I could knock the hat off of
him. No. Go ahead. I'm ready.
All right. Orange square. You hear that wallop down there?
Yeah.
Aha, we see something different this time. The wadding is not attached to the slug. It's not tumbling. It's still flying straight through the air. And remember, neither end of the slug is heavier than the other, so it really shouldn't be doing this.
So we pulled this out of Doug. Perfect condition.
Little mark.
Smacked him right here, 12 o'clock.
Oh, wow, in the circle even.
And
it went through it?
It bounced back out, but it actually cut a hole in the Kevlar.
Well, that was a pretty...
Beat up piece.
Yeah, that area.
I'm not sure if this piece of t-shirt's that hole was old or not, but
I don't know.
The
pretty good accuracy for 80 yards. What was that? 40, 30, 25?
24.
24. Okay.
24 YouTube yards.
It's the orange. You're aiming at the dude out in the street there. Okay. The invisible laser is on. Can you see it?
I can see it, but only I can see it.
Oh, okay.
I'm the only one that's TSA qualified.
The cameras don't pick up the invisible laser.
Yeah.
Okay, anytime you're ready, hit it. Wow.
Turned around.
Now, believe it or not, we were under the assumption this whole time that these things had to have been tumbling through the air, but were accurate because they were balanced and symmetrical. Well, there you go, folks. There's a 50-yard shot, only missing that orange square by a couple inches. I don't know how it didn't hit that bungee cord.
That one's stuck together.
Got a couple spots on the lawnmower engine that hasn't been hit yet, so we'll just aim at this cylinder right there.
Okay, this may ricochet, guys.
Yeah.
Okay, hit it. I'm gonna take out your terrorist go-kart rider. Wow, I just plowed through the fins. I don't think these are tumbling.
Yeah, it finally occurred to me that these things may not have been tumbling. We were looking at the aftermath of these things hitting the various targets, and they were always hitting nose first. We weren't reviewing the high-speed footage because it's kind of hard to see on that little screen on the camera.
Okay, let's shoot some ballistic jelly.
Okay, I'm ready.
Here we go.
Now, people are often really concerned when these things land in the dirt, and it can just be washed off with water. But as you can see the track going through that thing, it left a nasty wound cavity through this ballistic gel. These are some of the most surprising slugs we've ever shot. I mean, if I would have shown you that slug before you saw this footage, you too would have said, there is no way that's going to fly straight to there. It's going to tumble. There's nothing to stabilize it in any particular direction. And no, we did not shoot him through rifling, so we didn't have spin stabilization. So this thing was flying like a knuckleball straight through the air. Very, very bizarre. I sure hope you guys enjoyed this video. Be sure to check out Tim's channel. He usually shoots these things first. I have a link in the description. Also, thank you, Laura Platt, for letting me use your music.